With the wireless microphone system, the transmitter is on stage and the receiver is somewhere it can easily patch into the audio system. But when we use RF systems for in-ear monitors, or IEMs, this is reversed. The transmitter is off stage and the receiver is built into a belt pack worn by the performer. First, we discuss IEMs, which stands for in-ear monitors, which can be either wired or wireless. Then, we take an overview of this Sennheiser G4 system, which is stereo and analog, and then we discuss how using IEMs can actually help the front of house mix. In-ear monitors were initially developed and deployed in live music production by an engineer named Jerry Harvey, who founded Ultimate Ears, and eventually JH Audio, Jerry Harvey Audio, who makes wonderful sounding in-ears like these I have right here, which is their Roxanne model. Now, I go into more detail with these in other courses, but the ability to hear yourself anywhere on stage with really high quality drivers custom molded to fit perfectly in your ears has made IEMs the go-to choice for many professional touring musicians. Now, these don't always run wirelessly, and it is pretty common for musicians like drummers who don't move out of their positions on stage to just use wired in-ears instead. This just leaves out the wireless part and they are patched directly to the console. But for performers who move around on stage and don't want to be tied down to one spot, using wireless in-ears is great. Like I mentioned, this G4 system is analog, and that means we have essentially zero latency, which is definitely a positive for in-ears. Most often, we are feeding the IEMs with an aux send from the console, which can be mono or stereo, and in this case here I have a stereo aux send, and if we maintain good gain structure with the audio, like not clipping the outputs of the console or the inputs of the transmitter, then we should be in good shape. Now, since these IEMs have little tiny speakers or drivers inside of them, we need a headphone preamp to drive them. Just like the big speaker systems need amplifiers to drive the speakers, we do need a little tiny amplifier circuit to boost the audio signal, and this is what we control with the volume knob here. Now, one side note, this is where things can get dangerous, and considering the health of your hearing is really important. Blasting in ears with the volume knob all the way up and a loud mix hitting your eardrums can cause permanent damage. It's always best to start with the volume not at 100%. And quite often running these at 12 o'clock or about halfway up is sufficient, so please just be careful. But using in-ears instead of wedges can actually help protect your hearing in the long run. If you hear yourself really clearly, you might not need as much volume, and some musicians with really loud stage volume can get away with turning down a bit. Now, in turn, this can help make the front of house mix clearer and decrease unnecessary acoustic energy in the venue. Actually, I have toured with artists at the arena level who use no wedges whatsoever. The guitar is played through guitar amp simulators and all the keys and bass guitars run direct. And all the monitoring was done on IEMs, so if I turned off the PA, all you could hear was acoustic drums. Of course, this isn't going to work for every artist, but it did allow me to really control the sound in each venue, and it really did sound better than if we had a ton of volume coming from stage. In this video, we looked at how IEMs can be either wired or wireless. We looked through the Sennheiser G4 IEM system, and we discussed how using IEMs can help the front of house mix.